you for coming this afternoon. What a great mix of brass and percussion. If you were here for yesterday's wind ensemble concert, which I know many of you were here for that, you'll find that you'll hear some similar sounds, but you'll hear some quite different styles this afternoon. I'd like to thank Kerrigan Catlin for conducting the first piece with the brass band. She's working on completing some requirements for some conducting lessons that she's taking, and did quite some fine work with that James Curnow piece, Fanfare and Flourishes. We're going to continue on with this Ballad of the Green Berets. Those of you who have known the Mountaineer Brass Band for a while would know that usually in the fall semester, our concert, the thing that we're preparing for, and this is an ensemble that only meets, both of these ensembles only meet for an hour a week. The brass band meets on Monday afternoons, and we prepare for about 12 or 13 weeks up until November 11th, and we do a Veterans Day concert at the auditorium at the VA hospital up in Bath, New York. During COVID, we've not been able to do that because it is a nursing home facility and a hospital, and you know, for many reasons. But it's always a popular concert. So to keep us fresh, hoping that sometime in the future we'll get to continue those concerts, to keep us fresh with some things that we regularly do on those, this Ballad of the Green Berets is one of those tunes. A few years ago, looking for some things from the Vietnam War that would be like war tunes. If you go to World War I, there are all kinds of war tunes that came out of the war. World War II, you know, you can go back as far as the Revolutionary War. There were American anthems that came out of the Revolutionary War. The Vietnam War, this is it. This is really, and it's not really a you know, championing song, but it is a regal piece. Texas A&M University uses this as one of their fight songs. You can YouTube the Texas A&M, A&M marching band, and you will find they're a countermarch band. They go up and down the field, and in the process of doing staggering countermarches, they create these fantastic geometric shapes on the field. And this is one of the tunes that they would regularly do as part of their, particularly their pregame show. So this is the Ballad of the Green Berets. Thank you. So you'll recognize in, well, I hope you'll recognize in this Herb Albert Pops arrangement that we're about to play, the tunes Tijuana Taxi and Spanish Fleet. Drummers are doing double duty today. Some of them have multiple costume changes.
Thank you.
So the traditional brass band history is found in the Salvation Army bands. A big portion of the development of the brass bands in Europe and England happened in the Salvation Army ensembles. And so we regularly program hymn settings. And so this is our version of a Salvation Army hymn setting of Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus. Out 20 years ago or so, highlighted some traditional brass band music. The movie's called Brassdorf. Ewan McGregor's in it. There are some other sort of notable people in it, but it's a brass band film. If you're ever looking for just an entertaining film that has really good music in it, Brassdorf. It's about the coal mining industry in England and struggling in the 1980s and mines being shut down and the bands that were attached to those mines. There's a lot of brass band history in the film. This next piece, Death or Glory, is one of the marches that's featured in that film. So this is our version of Death or Glory. Thank you. final piece of the program. That's where we're at, right? This is the final piece of the program. Okay. So the final piece of the program, this piece called Cossack Ride and Slavonic Dance. I'll tell you this quick little story, and I hope you don't find it disrespectful in any way. I don't give it to you that way. This is a piece that I programmed on those Veterans Day concerts. And the first time that I ever did it on one of those concerts, I did it towards the end of the program, and I put it right after the salute to the armed forces. And after those programs, we have a little reception in the, for lack of a better term, a fellowship hall in the VA hospital there. And there are, of course, lots of veterans. And a couple of Cold War veterans came up, and they were rather upset with me that I had done Cossack Ride and Slavonic Dance after the salute to the armed forces. And so I came back and told the band that the next time I program this, I'm just gonna rename it. We're still gonna play the same tune, but I'm just gonna call it something like Happy Happy USA. And no one will know what we, so the band now refers to this as Happy Happy USA. So we offer to you now Cossack Ride and Slavonic Dance, or call it whatever you want. Thank you for coming out this afternoon. Hope you enjoy the concert.